Great. Hi, everyone. Welcome to FEBC New Zealand. And welcome to you, Vanessa, our very special guest today, all the way from Melbourne, Australia. Ooh. Welcome to New Zealand.
Thank you.
Great to have
lovely,
you.
Lovely country.
I'm sorry we're not in real life, but we are face to face in the new sense of the term. Vanessa, thank you very much for your partnership with FEBC. We appreciate you very much. So please tell us, you're otherwise known as the Trust Lady. Can you tell us a little bit about that? What's that about? And tell us about your work.
Yeah, thanks. It's interesting. It's a title that other people gave me. It's not something that I would actually have called myself, but I'd turn up at events and things and people say, oh, I know you, you're the Trust Lady. So the last 15 years or so, that's pretty much all I've done is spent time understanding what trust actually really is, what compels us to trust, why does it break, why does it hurt so much when it breaks down, and exploring, understanding it, researching it, and then teaching it around the world. I write about it every day and just really understanding it from lots of different perspectives, from our personal relationships, in a faith perspective as well, in corporates, in communities. So, yeah, it's
great.
A fascinating journey.
So individuals and businesses and churches, people engage you professionally to help them build trust. Is that right?
Yeah. Or to help them understand, you know, if trust is broken, usually when they come, or if they've got a particular focus on wanting to understand, you know, they might have the trust is our biggest value or trust is our greatest asset. And, you know, sometimes we'll say these things, but then they don't necessarily have a plan around that. So that's what I help them do.
So it's a very, very big word. It's a loaded word. And I appreciate that this question might be a bit mean, but can you define trust? Can you give us a brief summary of what is it when we have it?
Yeah. So I'll try and do it quickly. A lot of people think about trust and trustworthiness as being the same thing. And I draw a distinction between those two things. What trust actually fundamentally is our ability to rely on a person or group of people, on an organization or a brand, or the products and services, the things that we use every day, and we're relying on them to deliver some sort of outcome. So and we're placing our trust in things and people every single day, every moment of every day, actually. I basically unpack that in books and programs and things to help people understand. Basically, every single decision that we make is actually a decision of trust.
Right, that's massive. Okay, so we need to read what you've been writing. We need to visit your website. We'll come to that later on, because also we're partnering together at the moment to raise funds for FEBC's network and stations and ministry in Cambodia this spring. And so our New Zealand friends, many of them will have received our spring letter telling about a new program that we're supporting from New Zealand that we're raising funds for this spring. And you've written a book that we love. I love it. We are giving it away, and we'll give a link at the end of this video. So tell us about this book that we're giving the e-version to our friends.
Yeah. Well, you know, as I said, I've been sharing and working in this whole space around trust for a long time. And then a lot of people, Christians in particular, started to challenge me. And they said, how can you talk about trust without talking about it from a biblical perspective? And I thought, well, that's a pretty good question. So I started actually understanding and trying to unpack it from that perspective. I had quite a naive view, and then ultimately ended up going to Bible college. So I'm doing my master's in theological studies now, and you know, with this lens on trust in particular. So this book is The Ultimate Truth About Trust. It's a really simple book. It literally takes 15 minutes to read. It's got beautiful pictures and things in it. Because I love, you know, trust is such a big thing, right? It's such a big, big topic. And so many of us have been hurt so much, you know, have much betrayal and breakdown of trust. And so trying to distill that into something that's simple and easy for anybody to get their head and their heart around. So the ultimate truth about trust is really understanding okay, well, what is the problem here? What's really going wrong? And I talk about trust as very fragile, like an egg, and it's really understanding, okay, well, whose hands are we really putting this in? And from a biblical perspective, of course, there is no mandate for us to trust one another. It's actually all about trusting in God and then loving others. And so it really, you know, it unpacks that in a very, as I said, very simple message. But the feedback that's been getting around the world has been amazing. So
wonderful.
And I talk about, you know, I know it's one of the things that you love, Matt, the little, what I talk about, little T and big T trust.
Yes.
And little T trust is the trust, because we still have to live in the world and we still have to have trust with our partners and, as you said, between the, you know, the people who are delivering messages and so on. So how do we have that little T trust, and what does that look like, and how does that work?
Yeah.
And then big T trust is trusting in God for the things that really matter, our identity, you know, our lives.
Yes, so, wonderful. Yeah, I really particularly like that. I love the whole book, but I love the way you distinguish those. Living in the real world, little T, big T, trust in God. This is a card that we've sent out with our spring letter, and I'll put a link to it in the comments below. It says that the ebook is available for download, so people can download that book now from your website, and that's the link. And we say that this is a beautiful illustrated ebook to help you place your ultimate trust in God and his promises, and to rest your expectations and needs with him. And thank you so much. We really appreciate the way you've made this available. Vanessa, if people want to engage with you professionally, if they want to learn more about trust in their private lives, personal relationships, business, or church, what's the best way for them to get in touch with you?
Okay, so there's actually two sides. So the professional, the business side is on Tont, and it's www.ente.com.au. So that's all the business side of things, and there's all different programs and courses and things you can do there, and books as well. And then the more personal side is vanessahall.com. So
right. Wonderful.
There too.
Indeed. All right. We'll put that in the comments and make that link easily available. And of course, to support FEBC Cambodia Family FM, helping our network there to build trust in God, trust in people, and strengthen society, community, and those relationships, people can go to febc.nz and find everything there. There's links on our site to Vanessa, and there's a link on the Vanessa page to FEBC New Zealand. So thank you, Vanessa, for your time, for your generosity, for your expertise, giving yourself to this topic and to this work. We appreciate you very much.
Welcome. Thank you.
Great stuff.